To avail the adjudication facility, we need to go to the website of Department of Registration and Stamps, www.igrmaharashtra.gov.in. This website is available in two languages, English and Marathi. After scrolling down, we will see the adjudication tab in the online services section. It contains a subject introduction in the About tab, Adjudication 1.9, Adjudication 2.0, a user's guide, and frequently asked questions. We need to click on the Adjudication 2.0 link. We will reach the login page of adjudication. If user registration is already completed, then we need to enter the username, password, the CAPTCHA code, and click on the login button. To register a new user profile, click on the sign up link. Here we have to select the user category and entity. For user category, we have three options: citizen, lawyer, or builder. Then entity has four options: individual, individual with power of attorney, organization, or organization with power of attorney. If the entity selected is individual, then from the basic details section, we need to select the gender and salutation. Then we enter the first name, middle name, and last name. Select the state Maharashtra, then select district, taluka, and village respectively. Then we enter the flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. We can write the detailed address in the address box and then enter the PIN code. In contact person's ID detail, we need to enter email ID and mobile number. Then select the ID proof from PAN, driving license, voter ID or bar association. Then enter that ID proof number. Age will be auto-calculated after entering the date of birth. After that, we need to enter the occupation. In the username and password section, we have to enter the username and password for it. Password must contain at least one small letter, one capital letter, one number, and one special character. Password should be 6 to 12 characters. Confirm the password and enter the generated OTP. In case we forget our password, we can retry it or create a new one by entering the answer to the selected hint question. After filling in all the information, click on Submit button and our registration will be completed. If an individual with power of attorney is the selected entity, then we will fill in the fields from basic details and contact person's ID details as we have seen before. The details of the authorized persons are to be filled in the basic details of power of attorney section. That includes gender, salutation, first name, middle name, surname, then state, district, taluka, village, then flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name, address and PIN code. In the ID details of the power of attorney section, we need to enter the email ID and mobile number, identity proof and identity proof number, date of birth and occupation. The username and password section is to be filled as seen earlier. If the entity organization is selected, then we need to select the type of organization from the drop-down and enter the name of organization. After that, we select state Maharashtra, district, taluka, village are to be selected from respective drop-downs. Then we enter the flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. We can write the detailed address in the address box and then enter the PIN code. In the organization ID details section, we need to enter email ID and mobile number. In the authorized person's basic details section, we enter the same information as seen before, like gender, salutation, then first, middle and surname, state, district, taluka, village, then flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name, address and PIN code. In the authorized person's ID details section, we have to enter the mail ID and mobile number, identity proof and identity proof number, date of birth, occupation and designation. The username and password section is to be filled as we have seen earlier. If the entity organization with power of attorney is selected, then we have to select the type of organization like private limited company, public limited company, partnership firm, etc. Enter the name of organization, select the state Maharashtra, then select district, taluka and village respectively. Then mention the flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. Write the detailed address in the address box and then enter the PIN code. In the organization ID details section, enter email ID and mobile number. In the authorized person's basic details section, select gender and situation. Then first name, middle name and last name are to be entered. Then select the state Maharashtra. Then select the district, taluka and village from respective drop downs. Mention the flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. We can enter the detailed address in the address box and then enter the PIN code. In the ID details section, we need to enter email ID and mobile number. Then select the ID proof from the drop down, PAN, driving license, voter ID or bar association. Enter the ID proof number. Age will be auto calculated after entering the date of birth. After that, we need to enter the occupation and designation. The details of the authorized persons are to be filled in the basic detail of the power of attorney section, like gender, salutation, first name, middle name, surname. Then select state, district, taluka and village. Then enter flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. Then enter address and PIN code. The ID details of that person have to be filled in the power of attorney ID details section. Enter email ID and mobile number, select identity proof and enter ID proof number, enter date of birth and occupation. In the username and password section, we have to enter the username and password for it. As mentioned earlier, the password must contain at least one small letter, one capital letter, one number and one special character. Password should be 6 to 12 characters. Confirm the password and enter the generated OTP. In case we forget our password, we can retrieve it or create a new one by entering the answer to the selected hint question. After filling in all the information, click on the submit button and our registration is completed successfully. For logging in, we need to enter the username, the password, the CAPTCHA code and click on the login button. This is the dashboard for adjudication service. We see tabs like in making, data submitted, applications accepted by cause, query raised by cause, and withdraw application. Also in the left side menu under adjudication, the links new application, in making, data submitted, application accepted by cause, query raised by cause are given. And then there's link for refund. Click on the new application link to apply for adjudication. The adjudication form will be opened. In general information, we have to select the district, then select the collector of stamp office where the adjudication form is to be submitted. Four categories have been given in the article category: related to transfer for immovable property, banking or financial sector related, related to company affairs or miscellaneous. According to selected article category, a list of articles will appear in the article type, from which we need to select the article type and then select the document title. Then we need to upload the draft file. The file should be as per the instructions given for uploading the draft. Here, if the document is executed, then we select yes and specify the date of execution of the document. And if the stamp duty of that document is paid, then select yes here and then select mode of payment of stamp duty from franking, stamp paper, ESBTR or e-challan. If the stamp duty has been paid by franking, then we need to mention the franking MC number, vendor name, franking serial number, date of franking and franking amount, and then click on add franking payment details button. If the stamp paper is selected, then we need to enter the license number, vendor name, serial number, stamp date and stamp amount, and then we click on the add stamp details button. If ESBTR selected, ESBTR GRN number, ESBTR amount and stationery number should be mentioned, and then we click on the add ESBTR details button. If we select e-challan, then enter the GRN number and GRN amount and then click on add e-challan details button. The details that we have added will be displayed here in the tabular form. If the details are wrong or need to be changed, they can be deleted by using this delete button. After filling the details, click on Save and Next button. In the property details, select property type, immovable, movable, both or no such property. If immovable property is selected, then we need to select property subtype, state and district will be auto-filled. Then select the taluka and village, select property area that is influenced, rural or urban. In boundary type, select the boundary type from Jilla Parishad, Municipal Corporation, Mahanagar Palika, Nagar Parishad, Nagar Panchayat, Nagar Palika, MIDC or Cantonment Area. Then we mention the boundary name. Unit of the area is to be selected from square feet, square meter or hectare hour. Then mention the area. Port Kharaba is an optional field. Then we need to enter the property address and PIN code. Then click on Add Property Details button. At the bottom, we will see the details we have filled in the tabular form. If the details are wrong or if changes are to be made, it can be removed by using the delete button. If we select property type movable, we have to mention the description of the property and the description of the transaction and then click on the Add Property Details button. Details will be displayed in tabular form. If we select property type both movable and immovable, we need to mention the description of the property and the description of the transaction.
And then enter fields as we have entered for movable property.
And then click on the Add Property Details button. If no such property is selected, then the description of transaction should be mentioned and click on the Add Property Details button. Here we have to select attribute type, that is survey number, CTS number, etc. And then enter that attribute number. Hissa number is optional. Mention the area and click on Add Attribute Number button. We can enter more than one attribute. Attributes will also be displayed in tabular form. After filling the details, click on Save and Next button. In the Party Details section, it is asked whether the party details and registered details are same. If we select yes, the details which were filled while registering the profile will be fetched. For entering new party details, we select No. Party type should be selected. Then select user category and entity. Here select the gender and salutation. Enter name, middle name and surname. State Maharashtra will be auto selected. Select district, taluka and village or city. Then we enter the flat, door or house number, street or locality, road name and building name. We can write the detailed address in the address box. Then enter the PIN code. In contact person's ID detail, we need to enter email ID and mobile number. Then select the ID proof from PAN, driving license, voter ID or bar association. Enter the ID proof number. Age will be auto-calculated after entering the date of birth. After that, we need to enter the occupation. After filling the details, click on Add Party Details button. Details will be displayed in the table. Delete button is provided to remove the details. We can add more than one party. From the added parties, we need to save one as an applicant. After filling the information, click on the Save button. About stamp duty is an optional section. Here consideration or other valuation, then here valuation as per candidate's opinion, and here the reason has to be mentioned. If the document is to be uploaded, we need to enter the name of the document and upload it. And then click on Add Valuation Document button. Here we mention stamp duty as per applicant's opinion and the reason. If the document is to be uploaded, we need to enter the name of the document and upload it. And then click on Add Stamp Document button. We will see the uploaded documents in the grid here. After filling the information, click on Save and Next button. We reach the adjudication fees section. We are asked if adjudication fees have been paid or not. If the fees have not been paid, no is to be selected. Click on Save Application and proceed for payment. But before proceeding, read the instructions given here. We will be redirected to GRAS portal. Here click on the citizen and then select the make payment for penalties or other fees. The adjudication fee option will appear here. Adjudication fees 100 rupees have to be paid by filling in all the fields in this page. The option for payments are e-payment, payment across bank counter, SBI ePay payment gateway and UPI. After completing the payment, we need to log in to the adjudication service again. Our save form will be displayed in the In Making tab. View, Edit and Delete options are given here. We click on the Edit button and go to the Adjudication Fees section. Select Yes to the Adjudication Fees payment, then mention GRN number and date of payment and click on Submit button. Our adjudication application will be submitted to the concerned collector of stamp office and we can see that application in the Data Submitted tab. If the COS office raises a query, our application will be displayed in the Query Raised by COS tab. Here we can see the details. Here is the application number, here is the date of raising the query and here's the query. The action has View, Edit and Withdraw options. We can withdraw our application through the Withdraw button. We need to resolve the query using Edit button. The application has to be submitted again after resolving the query. When the COS accepts our application will appear in the Application Accepted by COS tab. When COS accepts the application is given a case number. View, open notice status and withdraw buttons are given here. If the COS takes any action, we will see those actions in the open notice status. If there's a document attached, we can view it and download it as well. We need to take the action against the action taken by COS and fulfill the requirement. Previous actions will display the actions of COS as well as the actions we have taken. The case will be closed after certification by COS. We can use the withdraw button to withdraw our application. Withdraw applications tab will show the applications withdrawn by us. For refund, we can click on the refund button. Here the refund link is given. By clicking on it, we will reach the refund module. From here, we can apply for refund. Thank you.